day go out for a little stroll. Why don't you go back to bed right here, and I'll see you in the morning.
You certainly had a lot of trouble sleeping lately. Maybe you should see a doctor.
I'm sure it's nothing, my dear. I'm just a bit of a night owl, that's all. Now go to bed. You don't want to miss your duty, see?
Maybe I'll have a couple of warm milk before I go to bed.
As a matter of fact, I think we're all out of milk. Let me just run down to the corner store and pick some up for you.
Dear, it's after midnight. The corner store closes at 9 o'clock. I guess we'll just have to go to bed and get some milk in the morning.
You go to sleep, dear. I'm just going to watch a little TV before I turn in.
Oh, don't be ridiculous. There's nothing on the TV this late.
Then I'll read for a while. You go count some sheep, and I'll stay here and read. Good night.
Well, you insist. Don't stay up too late. Just want a cup of water before. Where are you going?
Oh, my dear, you frightened me. I just heard something howling out in the front yard and thought I'd go investigate. It sounded like a vicious monster, or a zombie, or a giant werewolf, or something like that. It was a blood-curdling howl. Must go check it out. You stay here, and I'll be back in an hour or so.
Wait a minute, Buster. I didn't hear anything howling in the front yard. Now, tell me what you're really up to. Come on. It's about time you told me the truth.
All right, my dear. If you want to know the truth, I'll tell you the truth. You better sit down. I don't want you to be frightened or anything, my dear. You know I would never hurt you.
Of course.
I have a little secret I've been keeping from you since we were married.
Since we were married? Well, we've been married for 25 years.
I know. Believe me. It's been easy.
So, go ahead and tell me. What's this deep, dark secret of yours?
I am a vampire. There, I said it! Finally! I'm a vampire! Oh my, I feel so liberated! I'm a vampire! I'm a vampire!
What are you saying? You mean to tell me that you're one of those people who goes out in the middle of the night, biting people's necks and drinking their blood? That is ridiculous!
Yes, my dear, that's exactly what I mean. I love the taste of human blood. I can't survive without it. That's why I must go out every night to find my victims.
Well, that can't be good. How do you find victims after you drink their blood?
Oh, they're fine. It doesn't really hurt them. They just turn into zombie-like creatures and go about their day.
They turn into zombie-like creatures? Wait a minute. It's all making sense to me now. You mean Mrs. Harrison, the Avon lady?
That was very convenient. She came to me. Ding dong, Avon calling. Victim.
From the Taylor twins, Hansel and Girl Scout cookies.
I love those tag-alongs. Victim, victim.
And Rusty Fenton, the paper boy?
Oh, yes. He came a little too early one morning, missed the porch again, and, well, victim.
I thought the neighbors have been looking a little fatigued lately.
Anemic is more like it, my dear.
So, is that it? Is that all you've been keeping from me?
I may have fudged up my age a bit.
Your age? Why? How old are you?
700 years old. Give or take a few decades.
700 years?
Yes. Well, sorry about that.
Well, I suppose this isn't your first marriage either.
Maybe not.
Maybe not.
I vaguely recall a few others.
A few others? How many others?
Only 40 or so. Not that many, really.
40 marriages? I don't know what to say. That all makes sense to me now. I understand why you never eat my chicken fettuccine.
I can't stand the garlic.
And why you never Mother.